Meanwhile, back at home, Biden's getting his little panties in a bunch because Missouri and several other states have decided that the Second Amendment is actually still part of the Constitution. Missouri's Second Amendment Preservation Act, or HB 85, bans state and local law enforcement from enforcing federal gun control measures and allows citizens to sue police who violate the act. That includes, quote, any tax, levy, fee, or stamp imposed on firearms, firearm accessories, or ammunition not common to all other goods and services, any registration or tracking of firearms, firearm accessories, or ammunition, or the ownership of them, any act forbidding the possession, ownership, use, or transfer of a firearm, firearm accessory, or ammunition by law-abiding citizens, and any act ordering the confiscation of firearms, firearm accessories, or ammunition from law-abiding citizens. When the act was passed last summer, Missouri Governor Michael L. Parson said, quote, HB 85 puts those in Washington, D.C. on notice that here in Missouri we support responsible, law-abiding gun owners and that we oppose government overreach and any lawful efforts to limit our access to firearms. Since then, dozens of state and local officers have withdrawn from federal joint task forces. Good. Last Wednesday, Attorney General Merrick Garland clutched his pearls and said, quote, this act impedes criminal law enforcement operations in Missouri. Yeah, that's the whole point! Laughably, the DOJ has filed a complaint saying that HB 85 violates the Supremacy Clause of the U.S. Constitution, when in fact, it's those federal gun laws that violate the Supremacy Clause. The clause reads, quote, this Constitution and the laws of the United States which shall be made in pursuance thereof shall be the supreme law of the land, any constitution or laws of any state to the contrary notwithstanding. But those federal laws are not made in pursuance of the Constitution. They're prohibited by the Constitution. They're abeyant to the Constitution, not pursuant to it. At any rate, this is exactly the sort of action that Thomas Jefferson called the rightful remedy and that James Madison justified by saying, quote, if the deliberate exercise of dangerous powers, palpably withheld by the Constitution, could not justify the parties to it in interposing even so far as to arrest the progress of the evil, and thereby to preserve the Constitution itself, as well as to provide for the safety of the parties to it, there would be an end to all relief from usurped power, and a direct subversion of the rights specified or recognized under all the state constitutions, as well as a plain denial of the fundamental principle on which our independence itself was declared. The DOJ is asking the court to prohibit enforcement of HB 85 and claims that the gun regulations are, quote, well-established federal requirements for the registration and tracking of firearms and limitations on the possession of firearms by certain persons. Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmidt said that the DOJ, quote, seeks to attack Missourians' Second Amendment rights. Make no mistake, the law is on our side in this case, and I intend to beat the Biden administration in court. Hypocritically, the left is now repudiating the same principle that was used to support sanctuary cities. But as usual, with politicians, it's all right when we do it, it's just not all right when they do it.